Light takes time to travel. That means you're never really seeing the present. You're always looking into the past. If you're looking at something 1,000 meters away, you're seeing it as it was 3 microseconds ago. Look at a star and you're seeing it millions of years into the past. So what if Roblox worked the same way? What if every object only appeared when its light reached you? Alright, first of all, Roblox doesn't do this, meaning that transmission is instant. If a position updates 1,000 studs away, you see it instantly. There's no delay, you're always seeing the present moment. This basically just means, you know, the speed of light is infinite. But luckily, in Roblox, that just means no lag. In, you know, not the collapse of the universe. So I decided to change that. What if you could look into the past, see objects in the past, and even time travel? Sorta. Alright, so let's model light. So you have this part here that just spews out red balls. Now, these balls can be interpreted as photons. For simplicity, let's just assume light is a particle here. Now, if you move towards an object, you'd see it speed up because you'd be hit with more photons or, you know, information. If you were to move exactly at the speed of light, well, the object would appear stationary. And if you were to surpass the speed of light, then you'd see the object reverse in time. But wait! In special relativity, the speed of light remains constant in all initial frames of reference, meaning that this shouldn't be happening. Like, this is classical mechanics. Like, you can, you know, get past the speed of light, but you know, special relatively, no, you can't do that. We should actually observe the speed of light to still be the same in this reference point, meaning that even if we're moving like 100,000 studs or 300,000 studs every second, we should see light speed to be constant the same way. I mean, you'd expect that if we move at the speed of light, you know, like we'd see light be stationary, right? Like, we'd see objects be stationary. But, you know, I mean, let's just tackle this issue later, then let's just program this goofy version of light. I mean, all of these red balls carry information, so let's just create a history table first, where we store the position, orientation, color, etc. of the object for each time. Now, this history table is basically just our photons, essentially. So maybe we could take stuff from that history table and send it to the client via remote events. Now, each of these tables would represent a photon, of course, I already told you. Each table contains info like the position, orientation, etc. of an object. So now, we just have to find out which photon is hitting the player at each given moment. That's actually really simple. I mean, we just measured the distance between the player and the object, and we divided by the speed of light. That gives us how long the photon would have taken to reach the player. So, for example, a player is 60 studs away and light travels 20 studs per second. So, we're going to have to look for a photon that exited 3 seconds ago. And that photon is a table containing info about the object 3 seconds ago. And boom. You're looking into the past. Now, if you were moving 20 studs away from that object and you started 60 studs away and light travels 20 studs per second, then you'd always see the object as stationary, no motion. But keep in mind, this is only in this simulation, in this classical mechanics thing, basically. Of course, this assumes that the speed of light is not constant and changes depending on your reference frame. But anyways, if you move towards an object, you'd get hit with more photons and it speeds up. Also, technically, this is all client-side. In the server, the part has already fallen. Now, this works, but there are still weird stuff that happens. Like, if the speed of light is low, then you see your body parts get dismembered and walk towards you. And if the speed of light is high, then, you know, it's just normal Roblox, nothing is really changing. So, I mean, this is pretty cool, like, walking forward and backward reverses time, sorta. Even though, in the server, everything has taken place. So, how does this relate to special relativity? Remember what I said earlier about not being able to catch up to the speed of light? I mean, these are Maxwell's wave equations, which just implied that the speed of light is constant, which, you know, inspired Einstein to make his little theory. So basically, the issue here is that we want to find like an f of v, such that for every v, you find that the speed of light relative to yourself is always equal to c. Now, I mean, here are some notes from my journal notebook. Now, you know, I first tried c plus v. I mean, it kind of makes sense. Actually, no. I mean, like, how does your speed affect the speed of light? So I tried a different method. I mean, inspired by the, you know, the mirror stuff. So let's say this is our Roblox character and this represents light. So if we just hold W, then X is the distance we travel. Now, if we're holding W and D, then this hypotenuse is the distance we traveled. For this demo, let's just assume time is absolute. So from the first observer who's stationary, they see us travel this distance or this hypotenuse. So, I mean, just a squared plus b squared equals c squared, or square root of x squared plus parenthesis vt parenthesis squared, then all divided by time, right? But wait, but in the second observer who's, you know, moving with the same velocity, the speed of light is just x over t or c. So who's right here? I mean, if light is supposed to be constant in all inertial frames of reference, then these two things must be equal somehow. These two observers must see the speed of light the same way. So square root of x squared plus parenthesis vt parenthesis squared all divided by time is equal to x over t is equal to c. But I mean, solving this equation, we find that v must only be equal to zero. So maybe our assumption that time must be absolute is wrong, because we already assume v is not zero and x is definitely not zero too. So let's assume time is not absolute. So here's what I did. I mean, all I did was just change this t into a z. That's it. And if we simplify this, we get this, or, you know, this equation, which is
x divided by the square root of x squared divided by z squared minus v squared, which is equal to x divided by the square root of c squared minus v squared.
Now, if we substitute x is equal to c times z, then we can simplify this further by, you know, taking out the c squared in this square root. So we can simplify it to z all over the square root of 1 minus v squared over c squared, and that's equal to t. This is the time dilation formula. Z here is basically just our proper time, or basically the time you observe as you move with the speed of light with that, you know, velocity. And t here is the time measured by another reference frame. And yeah, that's the time dilation formula. Wow! Also, by the way, quick note, you can get E equals to mc squared once you know the time dilation formula, because, you know, you can probably connect it to P equals mg, or, you know, the basic classical energy stuff. And yeah, I'll end it this here. So our simulation in Roblox isn't actually simulating light, but, you know, it's still pretty cool. Yeah, even though it's not accurate, so. Also, yeah, I now have this YouTube member thing. I'll keep it simple for now. Now I just plan to add the names of the current members at the end of each video. And yeah, goodbye. I'll be adding more perks like emojis probably. And I'll make a part 2 for this video. Maybe.